Hi, I'm Mike.
I'm Don.
And this is the International Space Station Science Garage. It started, and I remember this now. You and I became astronauts at the same time in 1996.
Right.
There was no space station up there, but there was a lot of planning going on.
That's right. And we never thought it would actually fly.
I was very skeptical. Were you very skeptical?
I was skeptical. I was like, there ain't any way we're going to make this happen.
Why? Because we would get these briefings. We'd be sitting there in classroom with our, and we were a lot of people. We were 44 new astronauts, and they would tell us, you know, we hired all you men and women to be astronauts because we need you to help build space station. That was the thing. We were going to build space station. And I was like, I don't know. So why were you skeptical about it?
You know, I can't remember, but it just seemed like it needed 27 successive miracles in order to happen.
That's why I was skeptical, because the enormity of this project.
Yeah, the wall of EVA.
They call it the wall of EVA because we had at that point we had some EVA experience.
Yeah, we'd do maybe one EVA every 2 or 3 years.
Right, it wasn't very much. And then they showed what the number of EVA, they call it the wall of EVA because all of a sudden the number of spacewalks you needed to do to construct this thing, like if you looked at the chart, wham, it went way up and stayed high. So like everyone was going
to
go EVA.
It had never been done before to do 4 spacewalks on a 10-day mission would be just unheard of.
Right, and then you turn around and the next mission would have another
6 weeks later, you'd do another mission.
Right.
Maybe 2 months later, another mission with 3 to 4 spacewalks. Just unheard of. It seemed like successive miracles.
Right, you need a lot of people that could spacewalk. Yeah. You need a lot of time in the pool. Yeah. You need all your suits to work. So that was one thing, was the EVA. I saw that, wow, that's going to be a lot of spacewalks.
And it turned out, when you get a bunch of smart people that understand math and science and engineering, and they're working together on a project, you can do miracles.
And
that's called the space station.
This is what happened. The other thing that struck me was everything fitting together, right? Because you had stuff being built in Russia. You had stuff being built in the U.S.
Stuff being built in Italy,
up in Turin, right? Alenia? Is that the name of the...
I think so.
Okay.
Japan, right?
And
Canada.
Canada had the robot stuff going on. So you had all this stuff being constructed around the world with people who speak different languages.
Yes.
Right? And it's all going to somehow fit together.
And it's never been tested or fit together on the ground.
Right. So how is this all going to work? And I thought it was a bit crazy to think, because I, you know, just in my, you know, my own house trying to get stuff to work and fit together doesn't.
The first segment was launched, which was the Russian segment, the FKB.
And FKB stands for...
It's a functional cargo block.
Functional. So that was where the experiments were going to take place on the Russian segment?
It was more a place that had batteries and storage and propellant and things like that. So it was a cargo block. Okay.
So the FGB was the very first piece.
Yes.
That's the other difference between this and other construction projects, is that this had occurred in space.
Yes.
So you need to get your materials to space and people to space to build them, and everything had to fit together. And if you have problems,
you can't.
What are we going to do once we get the stuff there? So how is it all going to fit together was one of the issues.
But you look at the construction sequence of the station on orbit, it mimics a lot of construction projects that you see here on Earth where you want to build a freeway overpass, but you have to stop the flow of work on the freeway while the overpass is being built. Mm-hmm. So you'll make a little tiny feeder road off to the side where all the traffic gets diverted.
Temporary,
while you finish building the bridge or the overpass. And then when it's all built, then you'll remove the temporary road and everybody goes the way they're supposed to. Mm-hmm. And we used that kind of construction technique on the station, where we would put the P6 truss up someplace where it didn't really belong until we built the rest of the space station, and then we'd move segments around. So we had temporary structures on space station that were necessary to get the rest of the space station built.
Right, and stuff had to get moved around so you could get the thing
That's
done.
Right. But during that time, people were living on station, and it's kind of like living in the house while you're still building it, where you have a table saw set up in the dining room, yeah. right? And a bucket where the kitchen sink is supposed to be.
Yeah.
And then
people hammering and stuff.
Yeah.
Hey, cut it out, Donnie.
And then you find out that you have to entertain the boss for dinner. Okay. Mm-hmm. And that's like trying to do science during the first 10 years during the construction, because we were mm-hmm. actively building the place, yet we were still doing science experiments at a lower level. Now that station is completely built, we are starting to utilize the scientific capability of station that was intentionally built into it.
So we're now, finally now, we're getting to the point yeah. to really use it as yeah. as a laboratory that yeah,
as a laboratory that it was meant to
be. What with space station? These 15 years that space station has been up there. I mean, what? How would you? I don't know if we can sum it up, but how would you try to to sum up what has happened?
I would call
in these 15
it
years?
Grueling fun. Grueling fun. It was a lot of hard work. It's fun. It's rewarding. Involves all the cool stuff, which is math and science and engineering. Mm-hmm. And it allows human beings to go and live in a place where you can't, unless you bring these machines with you to mm-hmm. allow you to live. It's a frontier. Mm-hmm. And it's an environment that's different than living here on Earth, and it's rich in potential discovery. Mm-hmm.
So I think it's somewhat of a miracle in itself that it all happened. I mean, looking back 15, 16 years ago when we were involved with the planning of it and looking forward, that it all fit together as an engineering wonder, a great engineering mm-hmm. accomplishment, quite possibly the greatest engineering yeah. accomplishment
well,
ever.
And even in addition to that, it's a political accomplishment too, because you look at all of these different countries
right.
that have worked together to make this happen.
That's
and it hasn't been easy.
Right.
But there's this overpowering desire to make this thing in space, and that's helped everybody get through their little cultural differences. And remember, the beginning of this conversation, we were here as new astronaut candidates. Mm-hmm. Station was under construction and hadn't been built, and we had doubts as to whether it would even fly,
yeah.
right? Okay, now think of the scientific community. They're even more abstract from this, mm-hmm. and they look at this space station and say, oh, that's never gonna fly. Now it's finally up there, and they're saying, oh, but you can't use it for doing real science. And now, oh, real science is being done. Mm-hmm. So I think the science community has been slow to seriously consider what could be done on space station, and now they're starting to get engaged and saying, wow, it's built. Wow, look at all these facilities that are there. Look at this unique environment. I've got just the experiment that could be done on there. And so we're engaging more and more people. It's taken a while to do that, but they're starting to come forward with these wonderful ideas.
Right. So I think it's safe to say it's been, out of those first 15 years, a lot of it was construction.
Construction.
Really just the last couple were getting to use this
yes.
space station as a true laboratory. And the next however many years it might be,
yeah.
hopefully a yeah. long time, there's going to be some great stuff coming out yeah. of there science-wise. So the best is yet to come.
I like that. That sounds like Shakespeare to me.
Did he say that?
The best is yet to be.
Oh, cool.